Everyone, what's up, Gimian and IEA, and welcome back to another video. Today, we are going to be playing some Inside the Labs. Now, if you guys don't know, I have been accepted to join the content creator program for this game. I did do our first stream of it a week ago. So yeah, I really enjoy this game. I think it's a lot of fun. And yeah, we are going to be playing more of this. So if you guys like this video, be sure to hit the like button. And if you're new around here, subscribe. Your support really does mean a lot. And let's hop right into the game. All right, so we're right here in the single player area. There's different maps such as the Shadowbrooks, Old Town, Westwood, and Grove Laboratories. We're gonna go to random laboratories and let's just hop right in and yeah. All right, so the objectives, we have to identify the mutation, discover the subject's name, find a body part evidence, and fix 8 gas pipes. So we're actually on easy. The only difference is that we have less objectives. The more difficult, normal and hard will have more objectives to do. So, yeah. Also, if you press tab, you can look up the objectives. There are different mutants that you can that it can be. And we can also identify the mutation here. Find the objectives. Okay, so we found the wrench. That is what's needed to fix the pipes. So, yeah. Okay. There's nothing there. Also, depending on the mutation, it might or might not be easy or difficult to outrun. Only one mutation can instantly kill you, but it is very slow. So, well, it's slower than the others. So, yeah. I'll let you guys read that yourselves. Battery. I'm hearing a pipe. Okay, so we have to hold to fix the gas pipes. You can get injured by the gas pipes, so be careful with them. But yeah, we also have to find the body part and then find the subject's name. So this might or may not be a pretty big map. Okay, so that's 2 out of 8 pipes fixed. Okay, so there's the UV. We're gonna need that to get rid of some of the creepy crawlies. So here's a locker. We can hide in that, though. As of right now, depending on the mutation, we might be very difficult to outrun it. They are planning on getting traps so to make it easier to get away from them. But as of right now, it's very difficult to do so. But yeah, NDUV is similar to that of Devours. But right now it also kind of works on the things that I'm surprised we have. One of these. So if you right click, it will just disappear and then it will die and all that, which is very, very cool. Okay, so we have plenty of that. Okay, let's fix. Let's fix that. So there are other objectives like curing the patients, where we need to find a cure and a syringe. There's multiple other objectives. It's very it's well put together, I think. Okay. So we still need to find the body part. Oh, hi there. We may or may not have already been here. Okay. Yeah, let's head upstairs. Yeah, there. Okay. Second floor. You will know when the mutant would spawn. Okay. We fixed that gas pipe. Oh, hi. Those things can injure you as well, so be careful. There are also babies, but as of right now, they don't do much. But the devs definitely have a plan to make them do a lot more than they do right now. So, yeah, without. Okay, so we have the wrench. We don't need that because we didn't get injured yet. Okay. I kind of want to save the energy drinks for. Ouch. Okay. Yeah. So let's head to the third floor. That kind of hurt. So we don't have to do all the objectives, but we do have to do at least one of them. Okay, so this is an antidote, so you can get infected if you don't hide and the mutant gets you. So in order to... Okay, so we found the heart, which is another body piece. Okay, so I'm seeing fly, so I'm not sure if it's a grim freak or not. Okay, so we need to fix four more gas pipes. I see. I am seeing flies, which I'm still kind of learning how to identify each mutant, but I am seeing flies, so I don't know if that means it's gonna be a grim freak. Okay, so name evidence. So we've just need four more pipes to fix, plus we need to identify the mutant. There we go, goodbye. All right, so our flashlight battery is getting pretty low, so if we just press space, it will use up a battery that we have. So let's head back over there, because I do know that there is a battery here. Boom. Okay, so I'm hearing a pipe. Okay, so we found another gas pipe. Boom. So we need three more gas pipes to fix. I mean, we only need to fix three more gas pipes and figure out the mutant. I think we already got that, but if not, then you can... Nope. Not gonna let you injure me again. Oh, that is terrifying. Jesus! Mother... God, okay. Yep, so that's how you know that the mutant has spawned, and we saw it. Wait! It's slow! What? Okay, so it's a walker then. Okay. I see. Okay, so the walker is a kind of mutant that is... You can easily outrun it, but it will one-shot you. Okay, so it's a walker then. Wait, but it knew where I was. So, wait, if it knew where I was, what? Okay, that, I don't know why, I'm pretty sure I outran it. Okay, well, let's head out now, because I think, like I said, we don't have to do all the objectives, but I think it's a walker then. I think we're dealing with a walker, so let's leave and see if we got it right. Yeah, it was right! Yes, let's go! We got the correct mutation. All right, let's hop into another game. Okay, so we're in the Old Town Laboratory, identify mutant, subject's name, experiment type, and hack the laboratory data. Okay. So those are our objectives. Discover the subject's name, discover the experiment type, and then hack the laboratory data. Now, that is a little bit confusing because of the way it looks currently. But I don't know whether or not that would be fixed or changed at all. It is a little difficult to look at. I will show you what I mean if we can find it. What? Oh. Hi there. Okay, we don't have the UV yet, so...
This is
okay, we got that. That. Okay. We need to find the experiment name and the type. Okay, why is my flashlight flickering? The mutant hasn't spawned yet. So, more than likely, I'm just going to say this right now, it's probably a lighthound, because a lighthound is a mutant that can flicker your lights. Nope, it does its abilities when... Okay, so these are another thing. We don't have to worry about them, but those are the babies. Okay, so we are looking for the subject's name and the experiment type, as well as finding the laboratory thing to hack. Oh, hi, this is a new area. I see. You have the experiment type? Anything in this area that could be of use? Antidotes. Found the experiment type. Now we just need the patient name. Bacterial infection. Okay. I don't know if that is going to mean anything. I don't know if it's a hint. Okay, so here's the hack thing. So 7C, 7C, 9F, 9F, 37, 0E, B6, B6, 89. Alright, so you can kind of see that was a little bit difficult to deal with. Hopefully the devs kind of make that a little less irritating to look at. Okay, so how fast are you, Lord? You're medium speed. Wait, do you miss my fight? Okay, you don't. Okay, yeah, you flick on my lights. You could be a lighthound. Okay, so lighthounds are medium speed. I think lighthounds are, I mean, the main takeaway from them is just the fact that they are medium speed and they flicker your light, the lights. So I do think it's a lighthound. Okay, you know, I'm pretty sure I outran him, so yeah, the devs probably are going to have to fix that quite a little, because I'm pretty sure I outran the mutant, but for some reason it still found me. So, but I do think it's a lighthound, because my light was flickering quite a bit. So let's head out, and yeah, we could also do the other objective, which is discover the name of the subject, but yeah, let's just do that just because. And it was a lighthound. Okay, so yeah, the lighthound is the only mutation that so far that can actually flicker your lights. All right, let's play one more round and let's see what we can get. Okay, so we have to identify mutation, subject's name, experiment type, and again, hack the data. Okay. I'm surprised we didn't get cure the patient this video, but there's gonna be a lot more videos on this game, so we're gonna get cure the patient one video. I didn't even pay attention to what map we're playing on. Probably the one from the first round with the walker. All right, well, if something happens, I'll be sure to bring you guys back. I'm not even finding anything. Okay, upstairs. Okay, third floor, here we go. Yeah, hi. At this point, I think we're just waiting for the mutant to spawn, just so we can try and identify it and kind of be the end. Oh, you are a big guy. There you go. I am confused where all this is. Oh, hi. Oh, wait. Nope, that's just the battery. I thought that was something. Okay. Yeah, okay. So we found the name. Finally, we found something other than nothing. This is a new area. Now, the issue, we need to find the type. Yeah, the experiment type and the terminal. Now, as of where the terminal can be, I do not know. We also have to find the experiment type. I at least want to be 3 for 3 when it comes to correctly identifying the mutant type or the mutation type. Oh, here's the terminal. Found it. 77. 45. 6C. 50A, AF, 05. There we go. Okay, so we got that set. So I'm guessing now the mutant should spawn somewhere. Because at this point, I just want to identify the mutant and get out of here. Oh, mutant spawn. Mutant spawn. Okay, the mutant is slow. I'm guessing it's a walker. Yeah, it knows where I am. Okay. So, I'm gonna just flat out say it's probably a walker because it is definitely slow. So, let's head out. Let's find our way outside. Because it was pretty slow, so I'm just gonna go flat out and say it's a walker. If it's not, then, well, 2 for 3, so, you know, that would be good nonetheless. So, but I think it's a walker because it's slow, but let's see. Nope, it was a shade. Okay. Anyway, guys, that's going to be it for this video. I hope you guys have enjoyed. We will be continuing Inside the Labs on stream next week or this week, depending on when this video is released. So yeah, hope you guys have enjoyed, and I will see you all in the next video. Stay awesome, and as always, peace out, and have a great rest of your day, night, wherever it's for you. All right, peace out.